Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. He's a stellar award-winning gospel artist who's best known for crafting gospel hits like You Deserve It and No Reason to Fear. And with a chart-topping single and a new album on the rise, he continues to be one of gospel's rising stars.
And yes, she's his biggest support base, backing him in music and most importantly, marriage. Together, they penned a new book, A Miracle Marriage, to inspire all couples to keep their faith and family first. Please welcome JJ and Trina Hairston. Currently on tour, the Miracle Marriage Tour.
Yes.
Tell us about that and how it all got started.
Well, actually, he's been doing music for a very long time.
Of course.
Absolutely.
But we thought it was important to shine marriage in music. Mm-hmm. Because being in the entertainment industry, just the gospel industry, any industry you're in, you don't see a lot of strong families together, worshiping together, going back to the core of who we are. And we felt like it was important to merge those two.
Yes.
So it's really my passion for marriages and his passion for worship and music, and we brought it together.
So what kind of impact do you think this has been making on this tour, and how are lives being changed?
Wow, we've seen miraculous things happen.
Yeah.
We've even seen down to children praising God and being with their families and everything. So I think the impact has been even more than what we actually expected.
And what's been amazing is every show, every concert before, we sit down and talk to couples about marriage and what it should look like and what you should do and how you should keep your relationship together.
Yeah, right.
And then we go upstairs and worship.
Yeah.
So
it,
it's been awesome every night.
That's definitely needed, by the way. I hope you know that. Of
it
course
is.
You know that.
Yeah.
But what I like about you all, and I want you to talk to the viewers about this, how do you balance, you know, children time, time with the kids, and then time as a couple.
Yes.
You know, because a lot of times when the kids come into play, you know, you kind of forget about the love that that's shared between the two of you.
Sure,
you know, people begin to feel neglected. So how do you keep that whole and keep that balance?
Well, see, I think I don't say the word balance because when you think of balance, you think of each equal weight on both sides, and it's impossible to give 100% here and 100% there at the same time. So I kind of just set it as priority. What is priority for the day? That means that first of all, our marriage comes first. Kids are seasonal. They're going to grow up at 18, 19, and leave the house.
They
will leave.
Done.
And the important part is they're only going to model. Look at the babies. They're only going. They're only going to model what they see in the household. So it's so important that they see us spending time together. If that means locking the door, send them to bed early, whatever
we do it all the time.
We have to do it. We are, exactly. But my bedtime's not for 5 minutes. No, it's now.
It's now. So coming together to write this book, how were you able to like, okay, this is how I feel about this, and this is how I feel about this. Okay, so how is this going to make sense when we bring it together? Talk about that process.
So I'm going to answer that. My wife likes to be very detailed in her conversation. And for me, it takes me one page and I can give you a whole chapter.
Isn't that typical of a man?
So what we decided to do is give her point of view in each chapter and my point of view. So her speech is about 10 pages, mine's about one. But we both get our points across.
So I want to talk to you about one of the quotes that you have in your book. It's, you talk about forgiveness and how important it is. You said, for every bad thought, you know, that you have about your spouse, seize that moment to create a new memory.
Right.
Talk to us about that.
Well, see, we're very transparent in this book. We're dealing with a generation of people who don't like phonies. So truth be told, we had infidelity on both parts in our marriage.
Oh, wow.
And so it was a struggle for him to forgive. And so what I said was, every time you have a bad memory, don't stay there. It's okay to have it, but don't allow yourself to rest there. Let's go out on a date. Let's do something adventurous, something we've never done before, to create a new memory. And that way I'm giving him portion of, giving a portion to him that no one has ever had.
Oh my God.
Good job.
Yes.
There are cities that I used to hate, now I love
because
of the memories created there. Some of them that were a little bit that we can't talk about on TV, but we praise God.
But no, we intentionally have romantic moments in those spots so that it can outweigh the memory.
See, this is what working through a marriage really looks like.
Sure does.
This is what it looks like. How is your book different from other relationship books?
Well, I, you know, I don't know because everybody has their vantage point, and mine mine comes from, or ours comes from, a biblical base and experience. We've been married for 25 years today.
Wow.
Today. Oh, that is our 25th anniversary.
Are you going to make some new memories in Atlanta?
Yes.
We're so happy that you all are on this journey together to help heal marriages and make them stronger. We appreciate your ministry for this.
Thank you so much.
Absolutely. So those of you who are staying with us the full hour, we'll be talking music and a little bit more with J.J. Hairston. But can we give it up for his lovely wife, Trina Hairston? We appreciate you. And, of course, you can pick up their new book at A Miracle Marriage. Come on, Rashawn, wherever fine books are sold.
And the conversations always continue. Of course, it's Sister Circle TV on all social media platforms.
Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. We're still hanging with gospel great J.J. Hairston. We brought in Braylee Evans.
Yes.
Wow. And of course, is here in from Miss Trina Braxton and Selena Johnson today. We love having you here. Now
we get to talk more music.
Absolutely.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. I'm so honored.
Yes, absolutely.
But I do still want to kind of stab back into the book a little bit.
Yes. Okay.
So you have a new book out, your wife and yourself. In the book, it's called Miracle Marriages, okay? A Miracle Marriage.
There we go.
Miracle marriage. Okay, so let's make sure we get that right. That's A miracle marriage.
Right? Yeah, yeah.
So in that, you talk a little bit about the pitfalls that young people are falling into, not understanding what a relationship really entails. You know, what would be some of the marks or some of the tips that you will give to those persons in terms of how to really cultivate a true relationship and help them to avoid some of those pitfalls?
I think that we've concentrated so much on passion that we forget about friendship. And friendship for me and Trina was the most important thing. When we went through all of our issues, we became friends again first. And stop trying to be lovey-dovey and trying to be people who actually like each other.
Yes.
Once we got to that point, we were able to build. But before that, we were so caught up on giving each other candy and hearts that we forgot to be able to say hi and how you feeling today.
Yes.
So communication is the most important thing, and friendship is the most important thing in a relationship.
It really is. That's one thing I always say. I was like, I really like my husband.
Yeah.
I say that all the time. We will celebrate 17 years coming up this upcoming Saturday.
Wow. Yes. Awesome.
Thank you so much. So I really like him. During those times when you fall in and out of love, those undulations of love, like, I still like my husband. I think that's what sustains us.
Yeah.
So let's talk about this. There was a time where you obviously did not like your wife.
Yeah.
In the chapter, Pardon Me, there's a quote from Trina says, J.J. had the right to be angry, upset, hurt, and bruised. It was even healthy to allow him to feel those emotions after an emotional affair that she went through. How were you able to get through that? Because sometimes it takes men, I know that this is a blanket statement, a harder time to actually forgive. Mm-hmm. How did you do that?
You know what's so funny? I talk about that a lot. Forgiveness for me was a stronghold. I mean, even my family, we were known for holding grudges. We were like the Hairstons, you don't mess up with them because they.
Right.
But it came to a point where I realized if I didn't forgive her, I was not only holding her accountable, but I was holding myself hostage to the feelings I felt at that time.
Ooh,
so while I was hurting her, I was hurting myself every time I brought it up.
Right.
So I had to let it go, not only for her, but myself as well.
Yeah. And how were you able to apply that when you did what you did?
That's the thing. It's like, you can't ask somebody for grace that you can't give.
Right.
So how can I hold you accountable for something? Then when it comes to me, it's like, but let that go.
Yeah. Can you say that again? Because sometimes people feel like, you know what? I can do it to you, but dare you to do it to me.
Exactly.
Yeah. You've been in that situation,
and
right?
What I love about it is I've heard this statement. When you don't forgive someone, it's like you are drinking the poison but hoping they die.
Yeah.
Hey, won't that put you in perspective?
Absolutely.
So I love that you and your wife have determined we both not gonna drink the poison,
right,
and we're gonna live, and we're gonna let this marriage live and live out loud with a book and tell it all.
And we've been able to let all that stuff go, and we're at a place where we feel like newlyweds again.
Because our
first 10 years were jacked up, but
that's
now we're in such a good place.
Yes, I love the example you're setting for your children is just unprecedented.
Thank you.
And then let's get into the music. So the book is A Miracle Marriage, and then the hot new single is Miracle Worker, because he the one. That made that miracle happen.
Yeah. Absolutely.
So tell me some of the challenges or things that you may have encountered when you're coming into writing this
good new music.
The full project actually came out last Friday. It's called Miracle Worker. We're so excited. Mm-hmm. The song was written by a young man out of New York. His name is Rich Talbot Jr. Mm-hmm. And he was born with this rare blood disorder.
Wow.
And the doctors haven't been able to figure it out. So he's really, this is his declaration that God is a miracle worker because it hasn't affected what he does. He's walking around, living, talking, singing, and he's good.
Yeah.
And they're thinking that he shouldn't have even made it this far.
Wow.
So
miracle worker.
God is a miracle worker. And it's a full project, 16 songs, and we're so excited about it.
Sounds good.
So let's talk a little bit about the motherland.
Yeah.
It's very huge for you. Africa is very huge for you personally and professionally. Do you have any plans on going back? So.
Yeah, I'm going back in September.
Really?
Wow. My wife is finding out for the first time now.
That's a new memory.
Yeah. Yeah. What part were you going to?
We're going to Ghana. We've been to Nigeria 4 times in the last year. Mm-hmm. And it seems like every couple of months we go back and we're just having a good time there. The worship and the passion for God is so intense there. I mean, I've seen people walk for miles trying to just get to church.
To get there. Yeah. Yes. I got my passport. I'm like,
let's go.
You know, there's so much going on in the world of gospel. I don't know if you heard, but Devine Franklin is producing a biopic about Kirk Franklin. Mm-hmm. What do you think about that? And what do you think that will do, not only just for folks in gospel music, but just for folks all around this country?
Well, Devine, that's my dude. We're really cool. And what I respect about him is he gives the same production that anyone would make for a secular movie. So the fact that he's doing a biopic on Kirk Franklin, who is, at this point, the most iconic gospel figure we've seen to date. Mm-hmm. It's a perfect marriage. I think it's going to be amazing. And Devine will tell the story
like
right.
It's supposed to be told.
Exactly.
I can count on him for that.
Yeah. So it's going to be amazing. I'm excited about it.
Come on. So when the lights go off, you just chilling. Who is JJ Hairston? Like, what do you like to do? What's your self-care? Because men need self-care too.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know, I'm the most regular guy. Like, I sit down and watch movies all day long. My wife hates it. I could watch Step Brothers 10 times a day. but that's just my life. Because we have to travel and go so much, if I could just have my baby girl, my 9-year-old lay next to me and watch movies, I'm so good.
Well, you're good with us, and so is your wife, Trina. We're so happy about the journey you all are taking with your family. Thank you so much for being obedient to the call.
Thank you.
We appreciate that.
Thank you.
For his new album, Miracle Worker, it is now available on all music streaming platforms, so make sure you go out and get it. And don't forget to get a copy of he and his wife's new book, that's right, A Miracle Marriage, wherever fine books are sold.